Bit of a different episode for this one on the Princess. Episode 2, I think, or 3, I was starting to talk about wheels and what we were going to do wheels-wise. The obvious answer at the time was to use a steel wheel and get it banded, mainly because of things I touched on in that video. So the Jag has fairly big brakes and brake discs, which doesn't lend itself to small steel wheels like the Austin Princess would have come with originally, or other cars of that era. You know, 17-inch wheels just aren't common on cars of that era, and they look odd because you have to run lower profile tires. So I wanted small wheels over big brakes, which doesn't really happen. So I have the option of changing the brakes. I didn't really want to do that either. And there are some elements of the rear suspension design that you just simply cannot do anything about without massively restructuring all of that rear end, which we're using to hopefully try and make things easier. So I've ended up buying some new wheels, basically. And again, that wasn't necessarily an easy choice because it was expense I didn't really want. And I'm just going to show you the wheels. So the wheels I've gone for are Revolution 8-spoke Classics. So they are a very period wheel. You see them loads on, you know, Escorts, Avengers, loads of other kind of rally cars of that era. Revolution do, I guess, are known for making competition and racing wheels predominantly. They're not really like a fancy wheels company. They make function over form wheels, but their wheels also do look pretty cool as well, if you're into that. Yeah, if you're into a 1981 beige Austin Princess. So yeah, you're probably into the wheels that Revolution sell as well. So one thing I always wanted was a wide look at the back of the car, but I also didn't really want the wheels to stick out loads. I was hoping to try and kind of offset the wheel in. Again, that isn't that easy with how the back of the Jag is set up. It is quite a wide car, and offset challenges, you know, it's just not an easy thing to do. So 8-spoke Classics in silver. I've got the offsets, because again, they can kind of machine them to however you want within reason. So I've managed to get the offsets as close as I was ever really going to get them. I wouldn't have had a really any better wheel fitment with a steel wheel. And with a steel wheel, it was going to start to get expensive because I needed to band them twice. So we'll get them unboxed and have a look. So I've got the MIG 9J wheels on the back. They do fit, which is nice. The clearance is minimal in places, which I knew it would be. The cool thing about Revolution wheels is they will send you a paper pattern that you can cut out, hold against the wheel face, and it shows you basically the shape of the inside of the wheel. Now, of course, it's paper and you're required to cut it out yourself. So millimeter accuracy, you know, doesn't come easy. So I knew there was always going to be a bit of, okay, it's very close on paper. So when I get the actual wheels, it might be different. It is very tight in places. I will have to do some small modifications, but again, still a hell of a lot easier than having a banded wheel and trying to figure out exactly how much to band it in each direction, and then still not being sure of, you know, if they're actually going to fit or not. So yeah, they're on. They stick out from the body about 3 inches, which again, I want the original body width, but I also want to put wheel arches on it. So you know, you can't have both, unfortunately. And realistically, a 9J wheel could only have gone in another inch. The other issue with running a 9J wheel, again, I'm really making this difficult for myself, is there aren't a lot of tires that are available 9 inches wide, 15 diameter. So really, on a 9J wheel, the smallest you can run is a 235. And I want realistically at least a 50 profile, because again, I don't want low profile tires. I want to have that period look. So the only reason I was able to go for a 9J wheel, 15 inch diameter, is because there's one tire available. There is only one. And that is a Toyo R888R, which is a track day tire. and they sell that tire in a 235 50 15. So if they ever step, if they ever stop selling that tire, I'll have to actually change the wheels, because yeah, that is the only tire that fits, other than slick tires and competition tires that aren't road legal. That is the only one I can use. Anything else is too much of a stretch. You know, you can get 225s, 215s, but even with a 50 profile, you know, they're starting to get a bit too much of a stretch for what I would really consider not necessarily safe, but again, just keeping in with the look of the car. Again, they also need to match the front wheels, and I don't really want a stretch on those, so I've got to, I want them to look the same front and back, and it's quite a lot of guesswork. But yeah, there is one tire available, so because there is that one tire available, I was able to go to a 9J rim rather than an 8J. The only difference really on the 8 to the 9 is that I've got more width inside. If I'd have had an 8J wheel, it actually would have stuck out exactly the same, but I would have had an inch less on the inside. So really, I was benefited by going for a 9J. The only disadvantage is that there is only one tire available. Fortunately, it's a good one. So yeah, I've just got to hope that Toyo keeps selling that tire. I don't know what people are actually using that tire for. Again, a 235 50 15 is not really a common tire size. I don't know what cars use that. But yeah, I do now. So we'll have a look at the front ones and go over some of the issues with that. So front wheels. This is actually a bigger challenge than the back wheels, because the calipers are much bigger. So in that episode, I think it was episode 2 when I had the transit wheel, and I was really only focusing on the back, because that was where that was where the look was going to be really important. And I wasn't necessarily worrying about the offset at the front, because I knew I wanted a staggered look anyway. Now, the issue with the front is the size of the original Jag brake calipers. They are a big, big four-piston brake caliper with a big disc. And when I tried the transit wheel on, of course, they didn't fit. A steel wheel is almost always smaller internally than an alloy wheel. Don't ask me why, it's just how they're made. You know, they don't have any of the welded construction on the inside. But it was actually the face of the wheel that was making contact with the brake caliper, which meant that even banding them wouldn't have changed that. I'd have had to have run a spacer. I don't really want to run spacers. Not that there's anything wrong with them. You know, I just want to try and make wheels that fit the car properly without having to mess around with spacers and stuff. So these are a 7J wheel, because again, I want the staggered look. I don't need wide tires on the front. All that does is make the steering heavier, and it's not going to make the car handle any better, and it's rear wheel drive. So I don't really need wide wheels at the front, but these don't fit over the Jag brake caliper either. They're not far away. I need to investigate more. I might be able to, slim the caliper down. Not something you would probably want to say on YouTube, because people in the comments will go mad at you. The calipers for the Jag are cheap, which is good. You can pick them up on eBay for like, you know, 20 quid from Breakers. So what I'm likely to do is, in the area where the wheel hits the caliper, I'm going to grind it down, and I'm going to measure it before and after, and just see how long it takes me to get to that fluid gallery. Because realistically, I need to take about 1.5 mils off the caliper, and they're usually engineered to well within, you know, a good tolerance, because they get hot, you know. I'd be very surprised if I can't take 1 millimeter off of that little area of the caliper, which should make it fit the wheel. If not, worst case scenario, I've got to get some aftermarket calipers and potentially a smaller disc. I think I'll be able to get away with this disc with an aftermarket caliper, but going to an aftermarket caliper means an aftermarket disc. It probably makes more sense anyway. And when I say aftermarket disc, I can probably just get a disc off a different car, like a Ford Mondeo or something like that, that has the same PCD, the same disc offset, and maybe even a Ford Mondeo caliper. The S-Type front suspension doesn't relate at all to the Mondeo like the X-Type does, but I know the braking system is very similar, and especially how it actually bolts onto the hub knuckle. So I've still got options. I was aware that the front wheels might not fit over the caliper, and they don't. Obviously on this side I don't have the caliper on, but I think all in all this was the easiest and probably the best route to go down. Ultimately, I would have always felt like the steel wheels were a bit of a compromise. You can band them to a very good standard nowadays. There's a lot of people doing it. But I also think a nice set of wheels really does make a car, and I'm going to get that wide look on the back that I really want. So really, the next thing to do is get the tyres fitted. Again, get the R888R tyres fitted front and back. We're now at a stage where we can begin to think about dropping the car down on the ground. I'm going to add a bit more temporary bracing in front and back whilst we do that, which can be cut out at a later date. But we'll get the tyres fitted, get it down on the ground, and we can start kind of thinking about wheel arches and boot floors, rear tubs, etc., because we're going to know what the exact ride height of the car is with the weight of the engine in it. So the wheels were holding up a lot of things, which is why we couldn't really do much more work on the back of the car, because I needed to know what kind of wheel arch I was going to make and what the ride height of the car was going to be. So now we've got wheels, we can get tyres put on them, we can get the engine back in, get it dropped down, set the ride height, and really it's just fabrication from there on out. I'm going to have to come up with some solution for the calipers at some point, but yeah, that's not really a priority. I want to get the car rolling and ready to drive, really. So yeah, thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. I'm really happy with these new wheels. I'm sure there'll be some people that don't like them. I'm sure there'll be some people that think I should have stuck with the steels, but I'm really happy with them, and I'm definitely excited to see them with tyres on and the car on the ground.